Hey, this is Muhammad of Necrophages, and you are about to get your fix of metal injection right now.
I'm sitting here with Muhammad of a very awesome band. Now, I'm not going to say the name because I've heard many different pronunciations, especially here this weekend. So what's the proper way to pronounce your band name?
Well, actually, Necrophages, because it's an ancient Latin, ancient Greek word, and it means eater of the dead. So if you want to pronounce it correct, it's like Necrophages. But I know people have a hard time to pronounce it right. But we've been on tour in the US for 4 weeks now, and we heard like, I think, 10 different ways to pronounce it. So basically people say Necrophages, 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 whatever. Dude, we don't care, because it's such a, it's a name made out of language that doesn't exist anymore. So I would say that every way to say it is legitimate.
This is your first tour of the US. Yeah, you guys played some festivals, but how has it been touring the US? How's the crowd respond?
Well, I would say the best so far for Necrophages worldwide. I mean, what worldwide means like Europe and US. If I compare both, we have a good response in Europe too, but this is amazing. This is incredible. We didn't expect this because first thing is we've been told by our label Relapse Records that it's no good idea to come over here because they do not believe in us having a market over here, which we were like, okay, we got brainwashed like over a year. And basically, we were not supposed to do this tour, but it's doing very good. We sold out places like San Francisco, we sold out Japan with 600 people. I think that says everything, bro. I think people want to see Necrophages. It's just the fact that we didn't believe it to happen because we got brainwashed by our label. So basically, there's no tour support, nothing, because they said like, the tour is not gonna help the band, it's not gonna help the label, it's not gonna help nothing, but we see like the total opposite. Yeah. So this is like how the business works. We're happy to be here, we made it here, we pay everything ourselves, that's how our label is. So the American fans are one of our fucking best, man.
It's awesome.
Yeah, you know, I've been listening to you guys for like 2 years and I was like, man, am I ever gonna see these guys play? The best way to describe your music would be like super duper technical, you know? Now, I just have a simple question. Why are you guys so awesome?
What is awesome?
Awesome is what you guys are.
All right.
What I'm trying to ask is like, how do you guys write songs? Like, what's the songwriting process like?
Basically, I write the songs. I write like every instrument. I tab it out, send to our members. The musicians are so awesome that you just need to send them tabs and these guys just can fucking pull it off. Yeah. So basically, before this tour, we didn't play a show for 4 months. And we had a new guitar player. He never practiced with us. We had like 2 rehearsals. We came over here and it worked perfectly, because it's because of the musicians that make the band. They're awesome.
Now I was gonna say, you know, your music is definitely not easy to play. How do you find such amazing musicians to play with?
Yeah, that's true. It's been a pain in the ass so far, but right now, you know, I'm glad that it's pretty easy for us to find people, because we have more and more fans, and a lot of our fans are guitar players themselves. So basically, our new guitar player was a fan of Necrophages, and he just happened to be an amazing guitar player, so that's what happened. And basically, it works pretty good, you know? It's like, the songwriting process is like, I write the stuff, and we play it, and then we record it. Our goal is, of course, in the future, to incorporate the ideas of other people, but so far it wasn't possible. But up to now, it was like, because I didn't give a fuck about any styles, anything that was popular. When we started, our technical music and shit was so unpopular that nobody appreciated it. So it was we had a hard time to really stick to it and, you know, play what we want to play. And so that's what we did. And, you know, we did this for a long time and it pays now, and we're very happy about this.
Cool. I heard you guys recorded some new material. Is that true?
No, I'm writing new material for the next record. So we hope for a release date in summer 2007, and we hope to release it on a different label.
Are you guys done with Relapse?
Legally, no. But personally, I'm done with Relapse big time.
Gotcha. Now, I just wanted to ask, you know, like, how did you get into metal music? How did you get into guitar playing and everything?
Into metal music, my elder brother, he was listening to Iron Maiden, Metallica, and stuff like that. The old story, man. It's just the elder brother that got me into metal. I loved it the first time I listened to it. When I discovered death metal, the first time was like Leprosy, the album Leprosy of Death, and I was like, holy shit, I gotta play this shit. And I wanted to do a band, so that's the reason I picked up a guitar, not to become a guitarist. Basically, I picked up a guitar to make Necrophages happen.
What would you say would be your ultimate dream tour? Who are bands that you would be dying to tour with?
We would like to be opener for a band like Slayer.
You don't think Slayer should open for you?
That's a mean question. Of course not.
I mean,
you know, I know the guys from Slayer are like legends, and I don't know when they're gonna stop their career. And before they stop their career, for us to open for Slayer, that would be like a big, big, big dream come true. I wouldn't mind stopping my career after that.
All right, man. Let's get to some Necrophagist. Is that I say that right?
That's cool.
A metal injection.